Okay, next we are going to discuss the reactions of alkalis with respect to bromine. We saw the reactions of alkali with respect to chlorine. So we will continue the chemical reactions of bromine in this same chart. So reaction chart is continuing. All oxidation properties are over. Now bromine reacts with potassium hydroxide to form potassium bromide and potassium hypobromide along with water. The same reaction we discussed in the with respect to chlorine in PU part. So this is cold and dilute potassium hydroxide. So this is potassium bromide, all of you know. This is potassium bromate. Sorry, potassium hypobromate. Potassium hypobromide, I'm sorry. Similarly, next reaction, if bromine reacts with the hot and concentrated potassium hydroxide with respect to chlorine, what products you got? You got potassium chloride, you will get potassium bromide, but instead of potassium hypobromide, you will get potassium bromate. That is KBrO3. What is this? Along with water. So what is this molecule? So this is potassium bromate. And these two reactions are classical examples of disproportionation reactions of bromine. Similarly, when bromine reacts with the hot and concentrated sodium carbonate, hot and concentrated sodium carbonate, you will be getting sodium bromide plus sodium bromate plus water, sorry, plus CO2. Sodium bromide and sodium bromate along with CO2. Next,